Ladies and gentlemen, moving straight on to the next bout of the evening. This is for the Unity FC Championship title, which will be contested over 5 rounds in the lightweight division and proudly sponsored by Hard Life Fightwear. Your first fighter, 7 inches in the cage and fighting out of the blue corner, Harvey Stacy. And his opponent, stepping into the cage and fighting out of the red corner, Christian Bogus.
Stop playing.
Ladies and gentlemen, now for your official introduction, the fighter fighting out of the blue corner, weighed in at 70, he's at 26, stands 6'2". He fights out of Hodja Gracie Academy Boxing Hills from Ellsbury, Harvey Stacy. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, weighed in at 70.1. He's 19, stands 6'2". He fights out of Hard Work MMA and hails from Grimsby, and is the current Unity FC lightweight champion, Christian Vince Bogus. Your referee, Mr. Trevor Mitchell.
So, challenger and champion, Harvey Stacy, looking to take the title from Christian Bogus. a lightweight title holder.
6-0 versus 7-0. Two great records. Boga straight in. Oh, lovely body kick though, straight from Stacey. And a head kick straight after.
Oh, that was nice. It seemed to connect really well. Bogus looking for the takedown. Goes for the double.
Yeah, he's dragged them hips straight off the cage there. Beautifully. He's looking for that back take pretty much immediately here. Trying to break those. Lock, that lock there with the hands. Breaking the grips is always tough. It almost like he was going to go for the break and then into a Kimura grip. Which I think he still is.
Yeah, I think he's got it there, I think. Yeah, he's changed tack.
Yeah, he brought the grip with the Kimura grip there, so he's then tried to just contain him a little bit.
Bogus looking for that single.
Should have watched that neck though, we've seen a few times, a few chokes today. Big left hand though from Stacey, and a nice knee through the middle.
Beautiful head kick. Popping him out for fun.
Bogus taking some damage here. Oh, big knees down the middle, straight into the body.
Both happy to trade them.
Yeah, it looks like Bogus is now trying to throw head kicks back himself, but Stacey's trying to line that big left head kick up. Them knees and tight clenched knees are going to do some serious damage.
Good work, straight down the middle.
He can use that frame now. Doesn't want to be getting rid of that wizard. Wants to keep that wizard and maybe frame with the other hand. There, good work as he pushes off. Knee down the middle again and again. Big head kick straight after. Them head kicks are really hard to block because he's so long-limbed and so fast with them.
And he's doubling them
up.
Oh,
that's a big, big heavy shot to the midsection. Great work from Harvey Stacey. Christian Bogus on the back foot at the minute. The champion is being challenged here.
Yeah, Harvey really pushing the pace. Foot stomps, numerous shots, those dangerous head kicks.
Yeah, he took some big shots there from them head kicks. I'd probably try and disengage if I was Harvey Stacey in the next round and try and keep it back on that feet because he was getting some serious success there. That was a torrid first round there for the champion. Really, like I say, being challenged by Harvey Stacey.
It's so quick on that head kick. Just the way he doubled it up was absolutely beautiful. Just when you think he's safe and the first one's landed, the second one's already on his way.
Yeah, and then when he down switched it down to that body shot instead, you heard that around the arena. Unbelievable shot straight to the midsection. But Christian Bogus, with Madaz Flaminas in his corner, Madaz will be telling him exactly what he needs to do to get back into this. He's only a round in, but them shots were some big shots. And the young Hodger Gracie Academy fighter, he's ready to go again. Let's see if them head kicks start to come faster and furious once again. Oh, nice body shot there. A little front teep. Oh, a big head kick again. Stacey's shots just seem so quick.
Yeah, he puts them out really fast and with his long physique.
Goes that trip. Gotta be careful with that though. Now we've got the champion Christian Bogus on top.
Yeah, I would imagine Harvey's very comfortable here.
Yeah, he looks like he's trying to tie up an arm there. Or maybe go for a triangle. Gotta watch that triangle from this position. Especially again with the long limbs, 6 foot two. At lightweight, it's a big, that's a big tall lightweight. Trying to use them hips, trying to push off with his feet on the hips. Create that little bit of space. But Bogus is onto that. Keeping nice and contained. Keeping his hips low. Not trying to pass or really trying to do anything. He's got to watch them arms though. See when he's extending his arms onto the chest there, you have to be really careful because you've got someone with an active guard who's definitely trying to have a triangle or arm by you. Christian Bogus now on the back of Harvey Stacey.
Straight to the Kimura grip again. Try and break the hands.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to try and break that again and turn out. He's going to try and lift up and try and turn him out from there. He's struggling to get the grip though this time.
Yeah, Bogus is fighting to keep his hand down.
Yeah, he's trying to get that trip as well with that outside leg.
Trying to cut behind the knee, gets a takedown.
Got to take that nice there, but he's got that Kimura grip still. He's not letting that go. And he's trying to switch for that armbar.
Oh wow.
He's still trying to connect that Kimura grip, but the arm looks trapped in there now.
Yeah, I think it's tied
him. Yeah, he's got that.
Oh, he's got it. Oh, Bogus grimace there.
Yeah, he's going to be really careful. Not long of this round left, but he's going to be really careful. That Kimura. Oh, that triangle's on. That's tight.
So quick.
That is really tight. He's going to go to the armbar switch instead, but there's not long left of this, and that
oh,
is the end.
Oh, wow.
Wow. He was nearly put to sleep with that then.
What a transition as well. Fantastic, Jamie.
Yeah, he's got some serious ability on the deck, has Harvey Stacey, as well as his striking abilities. But Christian Bogus had a decent round there. A lot of his was more just sort of like wrestling, attacking, rather than any kind of submission hunting, where you've got Harvey Stacey, who's been submission hunting and head hunting constantly throughout this fight. Having a little walk about in between rounds, it just shows how cool and calm he is. He wants to get this back on the feet, I believe, but I mean, that triangle was so tight. Another 10, 15 seconds, that'd have been done, I think.
Yeah, it all came from that Kimura grip again. From the standing position to break the hands.
Nice kicks there. And goes for that high kick as well. Oh, spinning back kick there. But now Bogus looking to try and attack himself with a striking. Bit of a poor attempt at a takedown though from Harvey Stacey.
Yeah, it was a big overhand right. The plan was a good plan. Just never executed the way he would have liked it.
Still trying to get that underhook, trying to attack. It's that takedown now. A couple of foot stomps there.
They are incredibly nasty.
One of those that you feel more in the morning rather than at the time with adrenaline. Trying to get that trip again. Bogus does all the right things when he's in the grappling exchanges. He's got to be careful though with the strength and ability.
Oh, that was Harvey Stacey. Nice. Beautiful trip.
We're going to see a triangle attempt again. And here we are. This time to no avail. He goes for that guillotine. It looks like that's tight. That looks like it's right under the chin. From where we are. He can go for that Marcel Attin. He can go for that high elbow now. Can't quite get the hands together though. He's not got the grip on the hands. That is quite tight.
Stacey's fighting it. It looks to be deep.
Got a bit of a pant malfunction as well at the same time.
Beautiful, gets his head free.
Referee not too fussed about the pants, I don't think.
No, he's still decent.
Still attacking though from the bottom now. The champion. That eye's really swollen shut now. He's took some big headshots though with them kicks so far. And now he's trying to set up something from the bottom. Good up kick there. Nice step over though from the challenger.
Straight into mount position. Beautiful work there. Well, Rogus to push his opponent off, literally lifted him off at a mount position.
Yeah, he's in that side control now. Again, this has been, the challenger is really taking this to the champion.
Takes the back. A few seconds left in a round.
It's a frantic pace from both sides, and that is the end of the third round. And we're going to go to the championship round here.
Wow. So far, an absolute war between these two.
Yeah, there's been a good back and forth war, absolutely. I think that round again, though, Harvey Stacey seemed to take a bit more control in that one. Christian Bogus, the champion, though, you've got to take it to the champ, and he's doing that. Interesting to see what the corners will be saying at this point. The Hodger Gracie Academy fighter looking like he's just having a bit of a chill now, standing up, having a bit of a walk around again. He's had the chat with the corner and now he's looked ready to go again. Fourth round here, Unity Fighting Championships, the lightweight title is on the line here. Back with them shots again with them, that left kick, it's just a nasty kick, comes out of nowhere. He really wants to get that knockout with that kick, doesn't he? Bogus, he's just very tough though. Gets that drag down nicely there. The issue is you can get Harvey Stacey down to the ground, but it's containing him, isn't it?
Yeah, he's tough. Those long limbs just enabling him to be able to walk and stretch and move so well.
Big heavy hands there as well. He's pushing that head down well. Doing all the right things to defend here.
Nice wide base.
Continuing to relentlessly drag Harvey Stacey down to the ground.
Bogus trying to tie up those legs to crawl up the body. Tries to get the back.
Yeah, he's struggling with those grips though once he gets to the back of him. He's going for that little switch through. Big long arms. He's now trying to take the back from there. The arm's in the way though. That underhook is in the way. Bogus relentless with this takedown. Just pushing against the cage, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been a tough one for Bogus. I mean, at every opportunity, Harvey Stacey has had something to respond. So it's been difficult for Bogus. Every time he tries to get on his game, like even now, Bogus trying to work that takedown, but Harvey making it incredibly difficult as they climb the cage.
Yeah, he's pushing that crossface constantly. He's looking like he's coming. So as he comes under that chin, he's looking to make it really nasty, and he's pushing the head down at the same time as well. He's kind of crushing him, trying to get that takedown. He's now got that headlock. He's got to be careful of the back take from here, though. You can see Flaminas in the corner asking for that to come around the backside there.
Trying to move round to the back now, Bogus. With a head stuck inside.
He's still pushing that head down, he's still driving him. And that is the end of the fourth round now. We're going to go into the final round here. It's a tough one to call because really, you know, in that round, Christian Bogus just sort of held on and just against the cage. Didn't really do much with it, but at the same time, Harvey Stacey wasn't able to do anything back.
Yeah, it's a tough one because, I mean, Harvey started so explosively and for me, quite comfortably possibly took the first 2 to 3 rounds. But now, as you say, Bogus coming back into it, but not initiating enough.
Yeah, there's not much going on with it, but he's still attacking with it. The damage on the face so far tells the tale, though, because that right eye is pretty much shut up now.
Yeah, and then head kicks. May just be checking it to make sure that it's not going to cause any issue. No, I don't think it is. It just looks to be swollen under the eye. Medic speaking to the referee.
Yeah, I think there's a bit of blood in the eye as well, I think I can see. But that's not going to stop Christian Bogus, is it?
Fifth and final for the title.
Oh, straight in with that head kick again and again. Them kicks are so vicious, every one of them. And when he goes high, he can now go to that midsection as well because Bogus is trying to do everything he can to stop it. Setting it up nicely there. This is some beautiful striking from the challenger. And this is where the challenger does not want to be, though. Harvey Stacey wants to try and set that back now. He's trying to climb out that back door. That's a really nice switch on the wrestling there. And he can try and take that back from it. Can't see how much the leg's caught in. Yeah, the leg is caught quite heavily, though. He's going for the ankle pick as well.
Yeah, Bogus trying to spin with it. Careful not to give up his back.
Now this is where Bogus does not want to be now. The big, strong, heavy Harvey Stacey on the back, and he's on the back.
Both hooks are in.
Is he going to look to flatten him out, or is he just going to use this as a position to beat him against the cage? Continuing to go for this finish.
Fantastic resilience shown by Bogus.
Yeah, he looks like he's trying to feed that right arm through there. Can't quite see if he's got it under the chin, but he's trying to feed his right arm underneath it. Doing all the right things. I'd like to see some heavier shots try and open up that neck. I'd try and flatten out at this point now. I'd use that cage to pressure down, and he'll have nowhere to go then. Just not allowing Harvey Stacey to get that neck.
Sitting on the back up high.
He's now trying to work into that choke now. The only thing is the arm fighting and the hand fighting is pretty good work here from the champion, Christian Bogus. He's doing everything right to go 2-1 on the arms. Whenever he can, whenever he senses any danger.
Harvey dominating this round.
Yeah, this is a big round for the challenger. And this 20 seconds left, and this looks like the belt maybe being taken off the waist of Christian Bogus here. He's still going for it. He's still putting the pressure on right till the final bell. Fighting like a true champion. And that is the end of the fight.
Wow. It was a grueling 5 rounds. It had its moments of explosive energy. Submission attempts, KO attempts, some fantastic strikes. It'll be interesting now to see how the judges have scored this over the 5 rounds. Has the challenger done enough to unseat the champion?
Yeah, I mean, I personally, I'd say yes. I think the way He fought out of every round and just took the fight to the champion. Did exactly what he needed to do. Had some amazing submission attempts. I think maybe 3-2 on the scorecards that I've got here. But we will see what the judges say. And that is what matters to these guys. Doesn't matter what we say. It's down to the judges.
Gentlemen, after five hard fought rounds, we'll go to the judges' scorecard. 49-46, 49-46, and 49-46. All three judges in favour of your winner. And new Unity FC lightweight champion, Harry Stacy. Please show your appreciation for Christian Bogus.